problem.
Her name is Simone Boyce. She's our brand new reporter. She was an intern for me and then had a big career in New York and has now triumphantly returned to Channel 5.
Wow, look at that. Whoa. That's Simone.
Yeah.
She was an intern. You had her just like getting papers and bringing you water.
Yeah, exactly right.
And now, my gosh.
Look at that. Now Sam's getting water. No,
for her, honestly. You'd be lucky to carry her water. Right, let me tell you.
There we go.
I'm telling you, she did not eat one bite of that food. She picked it up. She waved it around. She tossed it. She would have fallen out of that dress if she'd eaten a bite of that food.
Paula Poundstone is here, and I love this, the totally unscientific study of the search for human happiness. And, okay, all the generic things you think would make you happy. Oh, if we only took dancing lessons. Oh, if I only drove a Lamborghini.
Yep.
And what did you discover, doctor?
Well, I'm not going to give away the secret, Sam. Right. You got to do a little work here.
Right, okay.
My book is a series. My book.
Mm-hmm.
Bam,
there it is.
Is a series of experiments doing things that I or other people thought would make me happy.
Right.
And each chapter is written as an experiment with the hypothesis and the conditions and hopefully the funniest field notes ever written. But the real question for me wasn't whether or not I would enjoy doing something. The question was, what could I do that would give me a bounce? What would give me, would form an umbrella, as it were, for the inevitable on and off rains of one's daily life? And so the analysis part of each chapter is the story of my regular life, of raising a house full of kids and animals and being a stand-up comic and just being stuck being me 24 hours a day. And its number one job is to be funny, but it goes in directions that even I wasn't quite expecting.
Really?
I can tell you, I was sleeping in a chair in your green room.
Right.
when I heard you guys talking about the importance of sleep to happiness.
Yeah. Sure.
And although I do not do a chapter on sleep, I really want to. I do a chapter on learning to use a computer. And and because I really was it took 7 years to write the book. And by the way, no dolphins were harmed in the making of the book.
Good to know.
But it took 7 years to do it, and I came to computers later than some people. Simone was already flying on a computer by the time I showed up to it. Yeah. I'm still haunted by the images of Simone leaning on a window in that.
Simone, a lot of people have it.
Were doing this, you said the book is things that you wanted to do and people advised you to do. Now, sometimes you get into that position and go, oh, this is terrible.
Yeah.
How often were you wrong as opposed to the people's advice?
I was mostly right. Yeah. Other people's advice was to learn to use a computer.
Oh, okay.
I had already written another book, There's Nothing in This Book That I Meant to Say, and I had also written three math workbooks with my high school math teacher, which were called Math with a Laugh. And I did those all by hand. I just wrote that. And then I handed it to a typist.
Right. Yeah.
And everybody kept saying, you'd enjoy using a computer so much more, and email so much faster than this and that. And you know what? Computers are a nightmare. What's interesting in that chapter, and I really did think that it was going to make me happy. I really believed my horrible friends. But you see this sort of sad decline into the compulsion of checking over and over.
Yeah.
Right? Don't you check? How many times a day? Yeah. You're probably dying to check right now.
No, I check way too often.
Yeah.
Not right
now.
Do you
do a Twitter thing?
Yes. We do all that.
And you check that?
I do.
Yeah.
Paula's book, The Totally...
Simone used to check that for you.
I know.
Is that a cupcake in your hand too, Paula?
That is a cupcake.
Okay. Then I should be your research assistant.
That was one of the choices right there. Simone won't check your Twitter ever again.
She won't even tweet me. The Totally Unscientific Study for the Search of Human Happiness is out now. Paula, new podcast live from the Poundstone Institute, starting July 9th on NPR, and just booked here. Paula, soon to be a guest on the Frank Buckley Interviews.
I cannot
wait. That is all hooked up. So
can't
we're
wait.
Glad about that as well.
I have the dirty backstory in the Frank Buckley interview.
we are tuning in. We'll get to
tell me all about it.
Very good.
Doping.
Okay.
Still ahead. Facebook getting.